Okay, what we have here is the skeleton of a mosasaur. We're at the museum at Georgia Southern University. That's the head of the mosasaur. And we are going down the length of it. It's a pretty big mosasaur, huh? Now, right next to it, with its tail up in the air, we have the skeleton of a vogtle whale, or a vogel whale. Do you see much difference? Mainly, the biggest difference is that the mosasaur is bigger. Now, according to Eugene McArthy of the University of Georgia, whales evolved straight from mosasaurs, not from mammals. So, what do you think? Let's go around and see what mainstream science has to say about it. Although the skeleton of the vogel whale is remarkably complete, several bones were not found. To create a realistic mounted skeleton of Georgiacetus, we use bones from other fossil whales to fill in the missing parts. The bones on the picture shown below are color-coded to show how we recreated the mount. In the yellow we have the cast of original bones of Georgiacetus. The reddish brown is modeled from 40 million year old whale fossils from South Carolina. The darker purplish color is modeled after Egyptian fossils of Dorodon atrox, a close relative of Basilosaurus, and the 47 million year old Rodhocetus Balochistan, I don't know what that, something Pakistan, but he was just telling me about that. Cast of the legs and feet of the extinct whale Rodhocetus, the ankle bone or astragalus of Rodhocetus is remarkably similar to that of the hippopotamus and is evidence that hippos are the closest living relatives of whales. Cast of 36 million year old fossil of Zygoriza caucho, another close relative of Belisaurus. Okay, the hip bone is similar to a hippo, and that's what is proving that the ancient primitive whales are close to land mammals, but how is it different than the mosasaur? That's the question. What makes it more like a hippo than like a mosasaur? Because this looks a whole lot like a mosasaur to me. And that's what Eugene McArthy says too. If you look at the other side, you can see how this goes. If you look, there's a timeline right here. Mosasaurs, mastodons, and evolution. You can see the formation of the coastal plain in Georgia right there, 145 to 65 million years. Between that and 65 million years, you got mosasaurs, and then you got the Paleocene, and then here comes the vogel whale. Now here's the thing that people don't tell you, that little tiny gap between Paleocene and Eocene, there aren't many fossils of anything. And just because we don't find fossils for mosasaurs for a little while, and then all of a sudden we start finding fossils of vogel whale, that doesn't necessarily mean that the mosasaurs went extinct and then the vogel whale all of a sudden evolved. It might mean that, guess what, we just are having a period where the whole world doesn't have much fossils because we went through a K2 event, a KY event, or you know, there's a period right there that ended the reign of the dinosaurs, Y2K event, and all fossils went very rare for that period of time. Now I'm not saying that that Eugene McArthy is definitely right, but I think it's very interesting that you got it the part of the UGA college system. You got two skeletons back to back, and it just kind of shows the question for itself: convergent evolution, or maybe a slightly different path of evolution than what we've been taught. The thing is, The Origin of Species is a very broad book that's written over many different time periods and many different species. Today, we've got people specializing in very, very small areas. So, you know, the Mosasaur people don't even talk very much to the primitive whale people because they're in totally different departments, totally different disciplines. And so we don't have anybody really trying to look at the broad picture of evolution anymore. Everybody's looking at the finite pieces, and they're not seeing the forest for the trees, possibly. You know, a lot of people will look at Eugene McCarthy's work and immediately assume creationism. This isn't creationism. It still follows the basic pattern set forth in The Origin of Species. It's just that maybe we got it a little wrong about the whole grand scheme of things. I have to study it more to find out if that's true, but just a hypothesis. We're going to look at Eugene McCarthy's theories in our blog and in some more videos, so hope you'll stick around and check out more videos. Yeah, the more I look at this, the more I realize that these two creatures are from the same evolutionary line. Eugene is right. I mean, come on. The only reason Darwin didn't recognize this is because he didn't have these fossils. If Darwin had have had these two fossils staring at him obviously in the face, he would have said, Mosasaurs evolved into whales. Every single bone on the hand, from the forearm, the elbow to the hand, is exactly the same. Look at that. It's just longer, but the shapes are the same. They both have the two flared forearm bones, same way. This is convergent evolution. Come on.